USA, flying Fijian side, lost to Samoa, but they beat Spain and Canada. Ben Golling's their head coach against Jerome Daré for France. An intense battle to see who gets through. After this is New Zealand, Great Britain. So the winner of that one face the winner of this one. We know Samoa and Argentina are already through. It's the HSBC Singapore Sevens. And referee Nick Hogan from New Zealand. Over 50 games on this series has the whistle for this all-important clash.
Yeah, perfect. Thanks, Shane.
France, three changes from last week. Fiji, Mothinathangi joins the group. Flags are flying. Everybody's ready to go. Full noise. Full stop 9 of 11.
You good?
On this thrilling 2023 HSBC World Rugby 7 series. So Mitchell hasn't called it yet, so we'll have to wait to see what happens in the next 14 minutes.
It's going to be a game of offloads. Top two offloading sides. That makes for some exciting sevens rugby.
Fiji on the right, kicking off to Le Bleu from France on the left. Bolobanaka, wherever you're tuning in for Fiji. And hello to our French supporters. It's knocked down at the restart. And France get the kickoff. Early position for over. Jonathan Logiel, who's been so good over the years. Paul Laretra goes in and goes out on the outside. Early doors to the French side. Brilliant bit of work from the winger. Into the 22. Pasquet is there. Stefan Perez moves away. Logiel linking well. Riba floats one up for JP Barak to skip on the outside, and he challenges straight through. France have the early score. They're on absolute fire here, and JP Barak smashes it down.
We've seen the fire going up in the stadium, and that's a hot start for France. Laretra straight into the game on the outside. What a great break. Does a good job here to recycle as well. Nearly loses it in that ruck. And then Barak, this guy's been a bit quiet by his standards, but he comes up trumps in the big moments and the big games, and he's given his side a great start here against Fiji.
Third highest point scorer in France sevens history has him at 7-0,
and no doubt this game's going to be a close one, so adding the extras vital.
Fiji winning the past 8 and 26 of the past 28 games against France, but that doesn't matter, those stats. They're just written on a piece of paper. The game is played on the field, and big Sevaloni Mothinathangi, known as the lamppost because he's that tall, takes possession as the 32-year-old for Fiji. Talatholo gets it away with possession finally for Wasia Nathungu in his 50th tournament for his country. Goes back to the forwards. Little switch there. Melawa finds Mothinathangi yet again. Such a presence on the field, and Nathungu still plays it back. It's okay as Josefa Talatholo throws in one hand. Mai Samoa, the good feet of Manuele Mai Samoa, gets a nice switch back on the inside. Nandavalo and Reba collide, and the ball has been lost.
It's just nervous moments when you're watching, and Fiji just throwing those ones, the ball's on the ground. They've retreated back about 20 or 30 meters, but that's so often when they just strike and penetrate the defense. But on that occasion, poor Riva got his little sneaky hand in, put his mitt inside to strip that ball. So you talked about Fiji being so good in this matchup against France. France coming in hot. They've won all their cup quarterfinals since Hamilton.
Sit.
Fancy another.
Yeah, bronze in Hong Kong, silver in Vancouver in recent times. Jefferson Lee Joseph for their flyer cuts in. Ball in one hand, potentially looking for the offload. Brought to the ground, it's there. Perez finds Logiel, JP Barak. Thought about a big pass, cuts back in. One of the French players is still down. It's Jefferson Lee Joseph is down there. And Paul Laretra, the 22-year-old, has it there. Ball's been kicked free. It's play on. Mothinathangi chases. Puts in a big shot as well. Ball is on the ground. It's anyone's game. It's flicked up from Fiji. That's what we love from the flying Fijians. Now they blow one over the top. Talatholo on the outside. Josefa Talatholo. A couple of big loping strides. And he brings the crowd to their feet. They strike right back.
Oh, yes, please. That's how you be more Fijian. Loose the ball, bouncing around on this turf. Those guys lapping it up. There it is. before he flicks it through the legs and they just move it to the space. Talofolo opens up those big legs. Perez quick, but he can't get across to close him off. And the big man, the grimace or a smile, getting his team into the game.
He was a wonder to watch last year, scoring all six of their games. HSBC Dream Team is voted by the fans last week as well. Continues the good form. Conversion unsuccessful, 7-5.
This is just sizzling, isn't it? What a game we got on our hands here already.
Now, we know the stats for France. The best side at retaining the restarts, 43%. Can Fiji get this all-important one? They batter it back brilliantly, and there it is. Up the middle they go. Couple of siding step. Fiji! That is outrageous! A score of note from Tero Velawa has the flags flying and they take the lead in the cup quarters.
Tero Velawa celebrates with his teammates. Like a flash, two on the board. Oh, look at that. Batted it straight back to his teammate who scoops it. One step and he's gone. What makes this Fijian side so dangerous? Before you know it, you're a couple of scores the worse off.
And the Rugby World Cup sevens champions, Fiji, 12-7 lead with a minute and change to go in the first half. Cup quarterfinal number three, silver medalists in Hong Kong, both Hong Kong events, and two bronze at Sydney and Los Angeles. Haven't won yet. Surprisingly, big hit from my Samoa. Perez does well.
No clear release.
To keep possession and sacrificing
no
his body.
No clear release.
And a bit of a breath for France. Talked about how this is going to be a game of offloads, but as you said, Dallin, the restart's huge as well. Two great teams at restart time. It's going to be a fascinating game within the game there. Burak will just steady the ship a little bit, kicking a touch. Good experience across the board, yeah. This French side. That man shot Perez as well. He's been there and done it for a while.
Okay. Just got a boot.
Yeah, early on in the series to kick things off, bronze medalist, and then a couple in the last two tournaments.
Good.
Side that have historically struggled in Singapore, but showing no signs of that this weekend. To the middle they go, it's contestable, and Fiji come away with this one. Good possession for the Fijian side. Nathungu comes back to the forwards. Talofolo keeps it alive to Mafanatangi, two of the biggest forwards in the game. Ball now goes to ground and Siliano Volivoli. Bounce ball for Nathungu. Spots a gap. Running on his hip. Good support from the try scorer Velawa. Big ball finds some of his taller players and Talofolo again. Great offload and catch. Fiji, Mafanatangi again. Oh, there is my Samoa. Runners queuing up, and then kick through from Talofolo.
Late tackle, blue.
A shot has come in here from one of the French after players, the and it's late. Beautiful.
Thank you. Late tackle, 92.
Probably have another go from this, I would have thought. They're clicking. They want to try and keep a bit of that momentum. France were desperate to hold them out. At the moment, France are committing two to a lot of these tackles, and that hurts you against this Fijian attack because they keep on coming with those support players.
Scrum. I need that decision quicker. Yes.
Here we go. Very different types of offloads, though. France are often those dumpy offloads where they'll then move the ball to the space. As we saw in that last passage, Fiji's offloads are to another player, coming at pace, very penetrating runners on their offloads. So,
bang!
A bit of a different style.
Set.
Yeah, great explanation of how the style of these different countries work well for them. Fiji with the final play of the first half. They're up 12-7 in the quarterfinals. My Samoa gets a nice ball back on the inside. Wasia Nathungu running on the hip. Space back on the inside. Fiji yet again. So many aces up their sleeves. And they score their third. And Tero Velawa is on the end of that one.
How do you stop it? My Samoa big step, draws in the second tackle, there Mafungu, huge for this team. Belawa, he's having a good game. He's enjoying himself. Striding away. France will be desperate for a break now.
The extra two from where Sione Thungu had set it up is successful. It is Fiji that are strong here in the first half. Half-time sounds and they're up 19-7 against France. In all sides, we know Samoa will play Argentina in Cup semi-final number one. But it's a business to take care of here. 7 minutes to go. And it's Fiji that lead 19-7 against France, who kick off to them here at the HSBC Singapore Sevens. Ball's batted down to Mai Samoa for Fiji. Ball is loose, and the penalty comes to the Flying Fijians.
At halftime, we heard French coach Jerome Deray trying to get his guys going. Ali Legao trying to G them up.
Taking the ninth, and time off for this injury. It's on the mark. That's on the mark.
Golling's very specific with his direction, trying to wants to keep the ball off the floor.
Yeah, but you can't take the nine.
Talks about penetrating with one runner and then getting the offload. We've seen them do that to good effect already.
On the big screen, the colour that we see here at every single stop, number 9 of 11. Here's the series standings. You take a look at Fiji and France. Of course, they automatically qualify as hosts of the next Olympic Games, but it's very important for Fiji to get in there. It's very tight at the top.
And they'll want to push a bit of cushion underneath them.
Are we going to touch?
They're all right in third, but they won't be too comfortable in there, and they'll be desperate to get that auto qualification in what is a very difficult Oceania qualifier if you end up in it. Potentially.
Yeah, right. Also spoke to Ben Gollins as well. He said, you know, it's so tricky and so difficult to compete at that top level, the top four. Anybody can take it. Just two silver medals and two bronze, uncharacteristically, have no gold for Fiji yet this year.
On the flip side, Jonathan Logel and his men. Those who have experienced missing out on Olympic qualification previously will be enjoying the freedom of knowing that they're already there, but they still put the pressure on themselves to deliver. They want to put themselves on the map in what is a hot French culture of rugby out there.
It's Jerome Daray, sixth season as the French coach, played for them in the first three seasons. Mai Samoa leaves the field. Talatola does well for Fiji, up 19-7 here in the second half, up the middle again. Wasiana Thungu keeps it alive. Belawa fires it away to the left-hand side. Talatholo is in another strong tournament, debuting in Dubai a couple seasons back. Fiji slow things down. Looking for a little break. Straight up the middle. Ioane Temba cutting them to shreds. Temba will go himself. Such a classy player. And Fiji extend their lead.
Getting himself in the party. Here it comes. Bang. Oh. How do you stop it? Perez coming across as the sweeper. No way he can change direction quick enough to stop Temba.
Topped the try scoring charts in Los Angeles earlier this year, and he's back at it again, coming off the bench. Five to play, and they find themselves up 26-7.
Smiles on faces, but for good reason. Not only are they winning this game, but they look like they're somewhere close to their best, which tees them up very nicely. They're able to progress into the next round.
Date with New Zealand or Great Britain await the winner of this game. Semi-final number two, France with Jonathan Logel. Need to find a way back into this game. Iragua on the field to spark some magic for his side. Pasquet links along the outside. Big step and movement in from Turabal. Comes into the side and a big tackle down to the ground. Rabage.
Time off.
He knows it. Balatha. We're headed to the sidelines here.
Go away.
The question is,
we need to check if it's directly on the head.
Yeah, that's the landing point
for
me.
TMO, please. Check potential serious foul play, checking where the landing is, please.
Stand by, Nick.
Thank you.
mantle into a dangerous position, and he's landed on his head.
Nick Hogan gets up the red card, and Napoleon Mbalapa will go to the side for the rest of this game.
You can see as soon as he completed the tackle, he knew it.
Oh, sorry, are you going to go for a scrum?
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. Okay, scrum.
Disappointed with himself. Not malicious, just didn't control the tackle well enough. You've got to be have the responsibilities of the tackle, look after the opposite man. It sounds strange, but that's the way the game is.
Sorry,
quite right too. And they didn't like it.
Number, please. 20.
Straight away.
France, with 4 minutes left on the clock, can come back into this game with an extra player.
Five.
Focus and concentration needed.
Set.
William Iragua. France to stretch it. Dribble on the outside, looking to take that space that's there. Cuts back in a couple times, well contained on the near side. Iragua linking again. France deciding what to do with Ryan Rabage. To the right, there is space. Pascal as well to Lagel. Jonathan Lagel against Mothin Athangi. Two big units going at it. The lamppost comes in.
Turnover's good.
And pinches possession as well. Great bit of skill from Sebu Mothin Athangi for Fiji. And France have it back now. Varian Pascal now with a bit of space. Pascal slides in for France. They are not done.
The fight back is on. Finds the gap after some good little contest on the far side. The ball went back and forth. Pascal's fired up.
We're doing something.
The ruck adds the quick extras. Varian Pascal, well, most offloads for France this season. He doesn't need it on that occasion. 26 points to 14.
He's a real go-to guy for them, Pascal.
Hold on, time is off.
And they'll need to go to him a few more times if they're going to progress to the semi-final.
Good to go.
Elawa on the side. Two tries from that man in picture.
Time on.
It's the restart we said. The most successful team.
Backwards.
They've knocked it backwards. Sefo on the field. That's what France needed. Mbokiyano gets over it, but told to release it. Iragua comes to Riva, now on the right-hand side. Barak, he fires one high over the top. Throughball couldn't handle.
Knock on. Before it went in touch. Yes.
You'd look to your man, Barak, to bring something special.
Knock on.
That time, just a little bit too much on the pass. Throughball couldn't gather it. Above his head.
No, it's not 30 seconds.
Such a classy player. Just not quite able to get the dip on that one.
Crouch!
Frustrating. Oh, the disappointment all round.
Bind!
Look at that stat on the left tackle.
Sit.
Completion rate 45% from France. Has him down by two scores.
I tell you, it's hard to get it any higher against this Fijian team, I tell you.
It really is. As here they go around with Filippo Bocchiato. HSBC Dream Team is voted by the fans last week. Same with our player, big Josefa Talatholo. Nice flick on the outside. Fiji looking to come here. Mbataranga gets it in field. Logan Amasi. Now Bukayano for Fiji. The crowd cheering him on. This man is as dangerous as a sneeze. And Fiji will take this game.
Well, what more could you want? That is special. Absolute quality example of offloading rugby. Talatholo with the first one. Then it's Batirarenga.
I felt he was reaching in his heart.
Offloads to Longinani Massey. And then it's just the wheels. Bukayaro. And the tale of two teams, two sets of fans there. But how can you not enjoy it? It's as good as it gets in sevens rugby.
It really is. And the knockout stages, day two of the tournament, they still deliver. Ioane Temba to get them going. Kick nailed as well. 33 points to 14. Fiji repelled with six players. And Neutral Stadium. Seffort releases it away. Mazzolini again. Another shot comes in. Good contact from Tambo on Iragua. France, more advantage here. Rabage to Barak. This time he puts a kick through. A chase from Trubal. It'll set up for him in the end. As Joachim Trubal will score for Les Bleus to close out this game. Time has beaten them on this occasion.
Trubal with a souvenir from this quarterfinal. A lovely, lazy, perfectly weighted nudge. Talking of nudges, might have been a little one in the back there on the chase through, but no complaints from anyone.
Front score, but it's Fiji that'll win this game by 33 points to 21. Fiji too strong in the end in the quarterfinals against France.